Hi everyone, I'm Sloan. Welcome to my channel. I'm about to show you guys what I got for Christmas. I'm probably gonna start with what I got in my stocking. Stocking is always so fun to open. So the first thing I got in my stocking is an eyelash curler. I've never had an eyelash curler before and I kind of don't know how to use it. Because the instructions are like, you put it as close as you can to your eyelid and then press down for 2 seconds and then like move upwards. But like it didn't do anything. So I feel like I'm doing it wrong. It's rose gold, of course. I love rose gold. It's from Amazon. The brand is thebrilliantbeauty.com. Yep. The next thing I got for my stocking were these makeup hair clips. I've been wanting these for a while because when you do your makeup, which I don't even do that often, they don't mess up your hair. Apparently they just go straight in and don't create like a crease or anything. I got 2 packs of these. In every pack there's 1 white, 1 pink, and 2 blacks. And I'm pretty sure these were also from Amazon, but the company is called Fashion Jewelry. Next in my stocking was this cotton candy flavored chapstick. I love the chapstick brand. This packaging is just so cute. And when you open it, it's literally like blue chapstick, which I didn't expect. It also smells good. I also got 3 nutcracker ornaments in my stocking that were from the Nutcracker this year. And I think it was like the Mouse King, the Nutcracker Prince, of course, and Drosselmeyer. And my mom said that they didn't have a Clara or an old Nutcracker. Her name is Marie. They're really pretty and they all match each other. They're all blue. Okay, now I'm just gonna go on to the presents that I actually opened. Where should I start? This is the Revlon One Step Hair Dryer and Volumizer. It dries your hair and I'm pretty sure it like straightens but also like a blowout. I'm so excited to try this. Let me take her out. You don't want to break anything. I'm really, really excited to try this. I read the instructions earlier. Apparently, if you have thin hair, you use like the low setting. If you have thick hair, you use the high setting. And then when you're like almost done, you switch it to the cool setting. I'm not sure what that does. And then if you want to have a blowout with the ends going outward, you go from the end and then hold it up for 2 seconds, I think, and then you go upwards. I might take a shower tonight. I'll try it then. It is time to try this out. My hair is like damp right now. I waited like 15 minutes after I got out of the shower. Okay, so I'm gonna put it on the low setting. That scared me. Oh my gosh. Ah! Separate hair into manageable sections with this much. Is this a suction? Like, I don't know. Place it close to the roots and brush it down. Did that do something? How many times do I do it? Okay. So far, so good, I think. I mean, it definitely dried my hair for sure. Next side. Now for the back. I can't see. I guess I can try to go backwards. So it says to get like the outward parts, you have to hold it at the end for 2 seconds and then go up. I'm calling this a success. Yay! But it is from Revlon, and I'm pretty sure this also came from Amazon. I saw it on Alicia Marie's, like, Amazon dupes. Wait, I don't know. I don't know what the video was called. I know she like compared this one to the Drybar one, which was like 3 times the amount. And she said this one was like the exact same. Right here. I don't know if you can tell what it is. I got a ring light. It's plugged into the wall, so I can't really pull it that much. This little thingy right here turns so you can like film TikToks or whatever, and then it turns this way so you can film horizontally. All these little knobs, there are three of them. You can like adjust the height, or it can like all come compact together and be like a shorter ring light. This knob also adjusts, and then you can like move the ring light forward or backwards. You can also adjust the light setting if you want it to be brighter or warmer toned, stuff like that. I'm really excited to use it. I'm using it right now. I put it together this morning and it actually wasn't that hard. I did it by myself. Figured out how to do it in like 20 minutes using like pictures off of the instructions, because the instructions were a little it wasn't that hard to put together, and I'm super excited to use it later. It's a lot later now, and I just wanted to show this cool thing that my best friend Kate got me. It is pretty much a tripod, and you can put your phone in this thing, and then this is a light, and then this is a microphone, and this is really, really cool for like sit down videos, because you have everything really compact together and it's super easy to move around. I'm also getting a converter. I can use the microphone that's on this, and then my audio is gonna be so good. So thank you, Kate, for this. I'm literally all stocked up now. Whoa, my eyes look so green. I bought my iPhone 11 myself in February, and I was gonna get a case by case then, but I literally like on my birthday went to the Apple store and got my iPhone 11, and then I was like, wait, I don't even have a case. I had to go to school the very next day. So we had to buy this clear Apple case, and it has some like scratches on it. But on Alicia Marie's YouTube channel, she had gotten a Caseify laptop case, but she had customized like pictures on the back of it. So I went and looked to see if you could get one on your iPhone, and you can. So I customized multiple times an iPhone 11 picture photo case, and I chose my favorite one. Oh my gosh, it is so cute. Pretty much put everyone in my family. I wanted to put like all my friends on here, but there wasn't enough space. I literally had to like reorganize this a couple times and like delete pictures and add other people onto it. I literally love this. I love the feeling of the case too. I've never had a case by case, and I love it. Also, when I like turned in the case to like be produced, I literally thought the pictures would be so blurry when it came out, but the quality of these pictures is so good. This exceeded my case expectations. I love the little sides of the case, like they're very bouncy. I talked about that for too long. Let's keep going. These shoes that I'm about to show are from DSW. I'm so excited. These are black little booties. Of course, have the chunky platform. I feel like you could literally wear these with everything too. I've seen people wear like chunky black boots with dresses, with jean outfits, like literally anything. I got a 5.5, and I feel like they're pretty true to size because my feet are teeny and these fit very well. They have like these little cool footprints. So they're from the brand Mix number 6. 10 out of 10. I like obsessed over this with my brother. I got his James Charles Mini Warpy palette. I can't wait to experiment with these colors. They're so pretty. Also the names, love the names. And the mini palette also has a mirror. Oh, you can see me in that mirror. That's scary. It's very chic. I love it. My brother got it for me because he knows how much I love James. Can you close? I also got another palette. This one is from someone who I've loved longer than James. Maddie Ziegler's palette. It's so pretty. Maddie is literally, has been someone I look up to for so long because of course she was a dancer, I'm a dancer. Her palette is also so pretty. It has a lot of bright colors, which I don't usually wear, but it also has a lot of neutrals. I love the color coordination though. I feel like this all goes together. My favorite color in this, I love 5, but I'll probably wear Maddie Girl the most. Or Godmom. Also, Posse's so pretty, like what? The next thing my dad got me himself is this little music box. And it has a little note on the inside. It's so pretty too. Oh, thank you, Dad. My grandparents got me this. I literally have never had AirPods before. They're so pretty, like I literally don't wanna mess them up. I just got a notification that said they're connected. Haha. Here they are. I already have used them multiple times. I used them this morning to listen to music when I was cleaning up my room because I got up early. I didn't want to wake my parents up. I can already tell I'm gonna get some use out of these. Everything Apple does is chic though. It's all like stylish and smooth. Apple's vibe is like so sci-fi. That makes sense. I feel like these are from the future, honestly. My grandmother also got me this little notebook that has an S on it. I love notebooks. I also love the colors of this. It has an S for my name. Okay, now we're on to clothes. I love clothes so much. I think most of my Christmas list this year was clothes. So I'll show you what I got. First off, obviously I've mentioned Alicia Marie like 20 times during this video. She's a lot of my like gift inspiration. I've been watching a couple people's Vlogmas, but all the way through every single video I've watched Alicia's Vlogmas. So I asked for her Vlogmas merch. It's very her vibe too, like the letters that are like glitching out. That's very Alicia, I feel like. And she's literally worn her sweatshirt like so many times during Vlogmas, so it's cool that like now I have the same sweatshirt. Also, I just love getting celebrities merch. I talked about it in my like 70 Christmas gift idea video, I think. I have loved Princess Polly for a long time. I think mostly because they do so many sponsorships with YouTubers. Like I've just seen so many YouTubers like get sponsored by them and then like try on their clothes. So I have become slightly obsessed. This is the first few things that I've ever gotten from Princess Polly. First off, we have these. Oh, wrong one. These jeans, they're so cute. They flare out at the bottom. I love bell bottoms so much. The only problem with these is that the waist is a little big on me. So I think we're gonna get them taken in after New Year's. I'm still gonna wear them between men. The color, so good. I also love the pockets in the front and the pockets in the back. And also the stitches down the whole leg. Very unique. I also wanted a puffer jacket this year, so I of course got one from Princess Polly, and I love the color brown. Something about the color brown this year. Love it. So this is more of like caramel. It's a little cropped, which is good, and it's actually pretty warm. It has these cute little pockets there, and then the buttons are the same color as the jacket, which is nice. The only weird thing I would say about this jacket is this collar thing. First time I tried it on, it literally was like over my face. But then I like pulled it down and it's better. Those were the two things I got from Princess Polly. Moving on to dancing stuff. Oh wait, not yet, not dancing stuff yet. I've never even heard of this store before, but I found them on my search for clothes. They're called Boohoo. They have really affordable stuff. This is like a little crop ball. I don't know, it actually doesn't show that much of my stomach because I feel like I have a short torso, but I love how the shoulders are adjustable because my shoulders are like small or something. Because a lot of the time these little straps on stuff are way too big. And then this is of course a stretchy material so you can stretch it farther if you need to. And it actually fits pretty well. I don't think they have zeros here, but I got a 2 and it fits, so. Then I also received this white crop top too. I like the lining on it. These will be perfect for summer. Then of course it has this little like, what is this called? Ruched material going down. And it looks like you could probably pull these strings and then it would like get tighter together. The string is like not attached to this, if that makes sense. Fits well too, and it is a size 2. I think maybe their size 2 is actually a size 0. Now moving on to dance stuff. Wow, there's really vibrant colors right here. The first thing I got, all ballet dancers know, bullet point. All of us have the skirts, don't even deny it. Well, if you don't, then you should get this one because it is chocolate colored and I love this color. It kind of looks purple right now. This brown one I can wear on the regular, my regular ballet uniform. It's a little skirt that you can wear in point class. Next up, we have this leotard. I don't have anything this like maroon color. I love the V-neck. I feel like V-necks are more flattering on a ballet leotard than like tight necks because I have a tight neck one and I love it, like I wear it a lot, but I feel like the V-necks they just look better. But yeah, the back is also open on this, and I love that because I can show my scar, and I love showing my scar. I really like this one. It is from Maria, but I got both of these leotards off of Discount Dance. Then this one, oh my god, I love this color. I don't have anything this color, and it is really, really pretty. But that's what the front looks like. It's kind of like a unit. And then the back is so cool. It also shows my scar. It actually shows both of my scars. I have another scar that you can probably see in the try on portion. That's like right in one of these bowls right here. I love this color. I actually really like the sleeves too. I think because everything that I got for Christmas isn't all about the gifts. It's about being with family and Jesus. It's the 26th right now. So happy one day after your birthday, Jesus. It's also about really good food. I hope you guys had a great Christmas. I also just wanted to come back and say thank you to everyone who got me a gift. My family and my friends. I didn't really show my friends' gifts in here. I'm really thankful for everything that I got. Thanks to everyone who got me a present because I love everything I got. And I'm really excited to wear it, use it. Love y'all. Christmas is my favorite day of the year, so the day after is kind of sad. Yeah, it's a little sad. 364 days. I literally love, love, love Christmas haul, so I'm probably gonna go watch like 20 after this. I think I'll be posting 2 times a week since it's break for the next week. Oh, I'm posting this Saturday, then Wednesday, then Saturday again. I posted this earlier Wednesday, I think. Yeah. I'll see you guys on Wednesday this time instead of Saturday. Bye, guys. Mwah.